3.5 lakh people of state board syllabus in the bio group. Only 80,000 people of state board syllabus applied for NEET. And out of 80,000 people, only 22,000 people got here eligibility. Out of 22,000, 2,100 people got into the medical system. The CBSE standard, where 400 schools are there, 4,000 students are there, 2,500 students bio group. Out of 2,500 students, 1,100 students are into the system. So you see this balance. So far, based on 12th standard system, 12th standard marks, what we do, out of 2,400 seats of government seats, and we have 2,500 private college seats, I'll come to the point later. 2004 government seats, we will surrender 15% of the seats to the central pool. The central pool selection process is based on an pre-MT medical test, where predominantly the central pool will be occupied by CBSE students, will come into the medical college system based upon that within the 15%. Because this 85% won't take up this 15% pre-MT test because it needs some type of training and selection processes, even though if you have completed CBSE. Now this 85% was enjoyed, I would say this 85% was occupied by the state board syllabus students so far. Now, after filling up the 15% central pool quota by the CBSE candidates had an edge over because the examination was conducted by NCERT board, who had access with very good coaching centers. They got into this 85%. And out of the 85% seats, first 2,500 ranks are government institutions where the fees is just 8,000 rupees per year. So for 5 years, it's just 40,000 rupees. We get a stipend during our internship period. So they occupy the first 1,000 to 1,500 seats. Now the state board syllabus people who were able to survive this onslaught, was able to coach up for NEET coaching center, got this 2,100 out of that 3.5 lakh, a pushback where they be occupying government seats in private medical colleges, which they have to pay a fees at least 2.5 to 3 per year. That most of the candidates have left because they were not financially enough to take up that even that particular fee model. So in this system, the need was thrusted upon us. And why Tamil Nadu alone is fighting? Why Tamil Nadu had an attitude of fighting? Because we had a successful social formula in our recruitment services. See, health and education was in the state list. During emergency, it was pushed to this concurrent list. See, Kothara Commission, when it was appointed in 1964, which is a central government appointed commission, where renowned UNESCO experts were in the part. Kothari went across all over India, studied all our states, gave phenomenal recommendations to the central government. And one of the main recommendations is, you should understand India as a pluralistic nature. You should understand each and every state as its own type of people, own type of culture, own type of orientation. The education should reflect the culture of the respective own people. The health aspects will be completely different in each and every pattern. So the health services and health education are interrelated here. So health education and health services are interrelated. So any attempt to push the health and education from the state list to the concurrent list will lead to confusion and deterioration of the particular sector. This was the exact words given by Kutar. See, my state has its own set of illnesses, has its own set of diseases. It can't be compared to the state of Gujarat, which has its own set of illnesses, own set of diseases. Uttar Pradesh has epidemics of hepatitis B encephalitis. Tamil Nadu has an epidemics of dengue infection. Northeast have a completely different problem. Now Tamil Nadu, since an urbanized states, we are moving towards a double epidemic. We are facing a lot of early onset of coronary heart disease, stroke patient. Gujarat still, they are not able to have adequate control over the vaccine preventable disease like diphtheria, polio and hepatitis. So how bizarre, how different the illnesses are. So I can't force a particular selection processes here to in the form of standardization, in the form of uniformity, in the stand of so-called merit, and force it up and collapse the health services of this particular country. What did I say? What did I say when NEET proponents irrespective of the central governments. The central government has an attitude of grabbing powers from the state. So they are not understanding the dialectics of federalism of this particular country. When the father of the constitution, Honorable Ambedkar, wrote the constitution, he said we should have a quasi-federal setup. Only in times of famine, emergency, a war situation, and center can override. Taking that particular loop, what has happened? A forceful emergency swept all the powers of the state, put into the concurrent list, and tried to influence outcome a DGHS, an air conditioned room in Delhi, will understand the acute cholera epidemic happening in Madurai. It's common sense. It's common sense. How come a person present in Delhi can understand what type of medicine can be delivered at the community level to prevent diabetes? Impossible. So each one has to, this system like health and education should devolve. So that system is not understood. According to my opinion, nothing is against India. Delhi is against India. You should understand. Single line. Delhi mean I'm stating this, Delhi central establishment is against India. Inclusive of the executive, inclusive of the legislative, inclusive of the judicial system, the center is against India. I will go to another example. When affected parties of state board syllabus approached the Madurai High Court, because the affected party is in the jurisdiction in that particular area, the then justice of the Madras High Court, two judges, framed up 12 questionnaires for the CBSE-NCERT model. How could evolve and one particular entrance exams for entire country when they have a state board syllabus, Anglo-Indian syllabus and CBSE syllabus? How come this particular board is given full empowerment to conduct an exams? How come there is a language difference in each and every paper when you say the recruitment is based on one entrance test, there is a language difference of paper? How are we going to answer the balance of 3.5 lakh people writing on entrance test, where around 2,000 people writing entrance test? Wouldn't they have an undue advantage to take up the exams? Are you not understanding the questions of the High Court? Are you not understanding it would lead to the proliferation of entrance coaching classes rather than maintaining the standard of each and every school? So the NCERT, CBSE board syllabus didn't answer even any one single question put forward by High Court. They went directly to the Supreme Court. Supreme Court said, all the High Courts of the entire country, shut up. Don't take up any neat cases. It's only we will dictate that. Regarding neat, it's a purview of the Supreme Court. Won't the Supreme Court know that in issues like fundamental right, we have to approach the Supreme Court? In case of issues like affected parties in a jurisdiction, whether like in health, education, or any other dispute, it has to be settled down by the High Court. So the Supreme Court has violated the Article 226 of the Constitution in regarding the issues of neet. Whether it's for neet, or against it is the rest of the matter. How come the Supreme Court, just like that, grab hold of the High Court purview over this matter and violates the own Constitution? Questions before you? So what was a real pull here? What was a real tempo here? See, our protest is very simple. Our demand is very simple. We had an assembly resolution. We pushed our respective political leaders, irrespective of the ruling and opposition party, to pass a resolution from the state assembly stating that we need exemption for our government medical colleges. Now the complaint is all the private players are propelling the protest. Be clear. We are not against neet for private institutions. We need neet for private institutions, for private medical colleges. We need neet for the deemed universities. But in order to preserve our social health system, in order to promote and protect our public health system, which we stand for as a shining, not as a bad example, as a good example for the following country to follow, we want our neet exemption only for government medical college seats, which is a matter of 2,400 seats out of 50,000 medical college seats in the entire country. Why people are so aggressive about it? Why people are so angry about it? Why those people are not allowing the 2,500 seats to be filled up? What the paradox here? The central institutes like AIIMS is out of NEET. There are 8 AIIMS institutes across the country. They don't need to write NEET. They're exempted from NEET. You told me, no, the NEET is a single entrance. It's not a single entrance test for medical education. The postgraduate institute of Chandigarh is exempted from NEET. Jawaharlal Institute, Jipper, which is in Pondicherry, is exempted from NEET. Chitratrinal Institute is exempted from NEET. NIMHANS is exempted from NEET. Because all central governing institutes are exempted from NEET. Similar way, we are asking our 23 government medical colleges to be exempted from NEET. That too, the 15% quota has been already surrendered to the central pool. We are asking for our domicile 85% Tamil Nadu government medical college seats to be filled by Tamil Nadu state board syllabus selection system based on 12. So that we have recruited doctors who could work for our system. Why are you not allowing that? Why are you so angry? Why are you so prejudiced? And so where does this prejudice arise? So you don't want, to be very clear, so you don't want students like Anita to become specialist or super specialist. Is that the prejudice? Sorry if I'm wrong. Let us talk openly. Why that aggression for this limited number of one particular seats? You don't want nephrologists from an oppressed community to be as assistant professor in Madras Medical Colleges or chief in Madurai Medical Colleges. You don't want it? You don't want it? So that's the prejudice. I will compare the cutoff marks. So far, they said that affirmative action gives people who are not able to study under quota system so that they get low marks and get into the mainframe. It's a selection process. We write the same exams pattern as everyone do, right? 1996, medical cutoff out of 300. OC 294 out of 300. BC 289. MBC, we have an inner reservation for MBCs, which is 283. And 269 for IC communities. This was in 1996, when I entered into. In 2006, you analyze the same cutoff. 294 for open, it's 297 for open, just 3 mark difference. 289 for BC, 295 in 2006. 283 for an MBC, 294 for an MBC in 2006. From 269 for an SC, it has jumped to 291 in 2006. So what's the inference here? People who have scored threshold of 269 belonging to oppressed community have to score in Tamil Nadu out of 291 out of 300 to get into a medical college. Is this merit or something else? I'll compare one more 10 years, 2016 cutoff, which is based on 12th marks examination. Cutoff rate for open competition is 197, BC is 197.25, MBC is 196, for IC is 195. That drop 1 mark difference. Do you think a candidate is being given allowances here? Where does the churnout have happened? Why did the cutoff increase? Because most of the backward communities are being into this churning off effect because of demonstration effect of the successful doctors in government. And they are able to see many people around, so they also started studying. When everyone started studying and studying and studying, naturally what will happen? The cutoff will raise. So the argument of merit gets destroyed here. The argument of merit gets destroyed. When you provide a proper access and proper opportunity, any particular human being can crack into the medical entrance system. So I bring in a new system and say this is the merit. And squash the other system. They said that Tamil Nadu, 85%, we won't touch your reservation system of 69%. We won't touch it, they said. So when we analyzed the milieu based on NEET, based on the 69%, we analyzed about each and every subcategory of each quantum of reservation. People belonging to a particular reserve community who are economically empowered, who are able to place their children into any of the coaching classes belonging to a reserve category, was able to score. Anita's father was a day cash member. I had Kausalya's father was an ATM owner, ATM bank security officer, ATM watchman. Those milieu are not here. I have central government employee son. I've got central government IAS officer son. I've got central bank employee son belonging to reserve categories, sons who are into the medical system. After math, do you have any social commitment from them? big question. Your institution is signing exam. Is there any social commitment from the reserve category to ascend up this order? They work, they come and they bus off. But there is a social commitment from the generations of Anita, from generations of Kausalya, so that they can take up the government exams. Tell me how many IIT products have took up PWD exams here? Tamil Nadu PWD entrance exams here? Tell me how many IITs are able to access into the system, government system, to serve the system, because you anyway you're going to study on taxpayer money. So Anita has a responsibility, she should have joined. Thousands of Anita have already joined. That's why our system is successful. Why you want to tamper this particular system? All India Institute of Medical Science, a merit-based selection process right from 1956 till now, 2006. In Delhi, AIIMS Delhi. Specifically, I want to say AIIMS Delhi because it draws around 600 crores per year for that institution. Because if the Supreme Court judges doesn't get well, or an APMP, they have to go to AIIMS only. So they've seen that the institution is equipped well. The rest of the AIIMS all over the India has been pathetic model. There's a Times of India article, the quality of AIIMS. As I was saying, in AIIMS in Bhubaneswar, AIIMS in Patna, where there is no even obstetric gynecology department, 50% of the capacity is not being filled up. There is no drainage proper facilities in AIIMS lacking. There is no radiology department in predominantly 3 or 4 AIIMS. That particular Times of India paper reports that the AIIMS is in a pathetic situation. Apart from Delhi, the other regional AIIMS are worse than the respective government medical colleges. Its selection process is based on NEET or any merit in system. Not based on, it's based on separate AIIMS entrance exams. They don't come under the habit of NEET. It's a merit-based system. 68% of doctors produced so far from NEET, so far from merit in AIIMS entrance exam are not in India. They are in UK and US health systems. 68% of the doctors so far produced from you and me, from our father's ancestor, taxpayers' money, are not in India. If they were in India, incident like Gorakhpur wouldn't have been happened. Come to Tamil Nadu. We have a social recruitment policy based on affirmative action, which is from 1927 so far. We have district medical colleges in each and every district. 71% of doctors produced from Tamil Nadu are in Tamil Nadu. And 52% of doctors are in government services. Now, where is the merit here? Where is the selection process here? If an upper privileged community studies medicine, the benefit is for him. Is the benefit for him? If an associate underprivileged community like Anita becomes a doctor, the benefit is for the society. So a country like India, a developing country like India, should gauge whether an individual promotion, individual development is important, or a collective individual involvement should be sustained. Whether I need persons for an high-tech cardiac thoracic surgery, or I need persons who deal with 1,000 neonatal babies down in a low-down district. What should a country like India should decide? Whether before delivering any type of judgments, or before delivering any type of policies, whether these policymakers have taken into this ground situation? Whether the courts, before delivering any judgment, have taken into this foreign consideration? It's a big question mark here. NEET will improve the school syllabus. That's an argument they're facing. NEET will improve the school syllabus. It's a common sense. The outcome of a single entrance exam will improve a school syllabus. Any reformation should start from down, right? It's common sense. You develop one particular entrance exam and you match the schools according to that. That's not the yardstick. Now what has happened? Junior NEET. 6, 7, 8 junior NEET. You can make your son and daughters to study NEET right from 6, 7, 8. Weekly 3 classes. Package 40,000 to 1 lakh. Senior NEET. 9, 10, 11, 12. Senior NEET. Everyday classes, evening classes. Early morning 5 to 6 classes. Night time 5 to 6 classes. 1.5 to 3 your package with boarding facilities. Cash course NEET. 3 months NEET after you finishing exams. Online NEET. If you finish NEET 1 year, don't worry, you can go back again with the boarding facility, study for the second year. You can also study for the third year. So it's obvious, in the first batch of Madras Medical College, 61% of students in Madras Medical College sitting in the anatomy ground right now, which is selections based on NEET, have already completed 12th last year. So what is the clue is, they have been into a coaching system to get into. So when you have coached well, you are cutting the exam, that's it. Similar to this institution also, right? I don't see your school Principals will give you interviews that my student has gone into this IIT Chennai, IIT Kanpur. It's IIT G director will give you interviews.